Where are we, Lara?
Here at Haleakala National Park. We're looking at from above the park.
How many feet are we?
9,000 feet.
9,000 feet. And what's the weather like up here?
Windy and chilly, but really nice.
Windy but chilly, but really nice.
Really refreshing.
With goosebumps.
Yeah.
On the drive up, there's plenty of places to stop as well and look out. You can just see the clouds.
We're above the clouds, aren't we? It's great. Is there a big snake here? So Lara, what are the two things that are unique to Haleakala?
Number one is the silver sod, which is a silver plant. It's their silver.
It's silver.
The second thing is the nini.
And what's that?
It looks like a duck.
But what is it?
Or a
really?
Bird.
It is really a duck.
It's actually a wild goose.
Oh. You are now in Kuamoana, the land above the clouds, where people know the world belongs. The landscape of Haleakala National Park rises from a lush valley beneath a waterfall at sea level to a red desert of cinder cones here at the volcanic summit of Haleakala. An astounding array of climates and life zones lies in between. The summit of Haleakala is an island atop a volcanic island with its own distinctive climate and habitats. Its cinder desert is sometimes frozen and seemingly barren, yet a variety of creatures and unique plants like the ahinahina, silver sword, have adapted to the summit's extremes. Despite the contrast to seashells of Maui, the summit is connected to the rest of the island in critical ways. The upper slopes capture moisture to nourish the rainforest of Kipahumu and feed the streams and waterfalls in the valleys. The summit also preserves portions of the original Hawaii, including native vegetation and evidence of the early inhabitants.